Indonesia associates itself with this statement delivered by Ambassador Haifa Aissami Mada of Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela on behalf of the NAM state parties to the convention and China. In addition, Mr. Chairman, allow me briefly also to convey statements on national capacity. Mr. Chairman, Mr. Director General and distinguished delegates, Indonesia wishes to underscore once again the balance among the important pillars set forth in the Chemical Weapons Convention. Firstly, a world free of chemical weapons can be achieved through universality, full compliance, and effective implementations of all provisions of the convention by state parties. Indonesia therefore reiterates its call upon few remaining states outside the conventions to join the organizations, as universal acceptance to the conventions is crucial to its success. Indonesia commends significant progress, including an achievement in the completion of the verified destruction of Russia's chemical weapons program. Meanwhile, the other possessor states and related states must still undertake further necessary measures to accelerate complete destruction of all categories of chemical weapons in its due course. Complete disarmament and non-proliferations are mutually reinforcing and are essentials for strengthening international peace and security. However, while celebrating the 20th anniversary of the entry into force of the convention, chemical weapons used, such as in Khan Sakyun, as reported recently by fact-finding missions and joint investigative mechanisms, have nevertheless raised new challenges. It has been our consistent and principled positions that chemical weapons used by anyone, anywhere, and under any circumstances must be condemned. Secondly, effective verification is an essential feature for attaining non-proliferation and confidence building. Indonesia has no interest in possessing, producing, developing, or using chemical weapons. The Technical Secretariat has conducted verification and inspections in various industrial sites in Indonesia with satisfactory results. Thirdly, strengthening international cooperation and assistance, as well as peaceful uses of chemistry for Indonesia, are among the foremost elements of the conventions. State parties and the OPCW should enhance their collective efforts to strengthen cooperation, including capacity building activities in the area of chemical safety and security, as well as in preventing and responding to chemical terrorism by non-state actors who poses a threat and that the international community cannot afford. In terms of chemical security, Indonesia supports the open-ended working group on terrorism and its sub-working groups on non-state actors to work continuously with forward-looking priorities, as well as to explore the possible directions with which the OPCW should deal with in the future. Likewise, Indonesia encouraged the open-ended working group on future priorities to enhance and deepen discussions on the issues relating to chemical security, including the mounting challenges of threats by non-state actors, and welcomes further their useful work to attain its end in preparations of the fourth review conference in 2018. In considering, Indonesia sincerely believes that an integrated approach is necessary in the works between the open-ended working group on terrorism and the open-ended working group on future priorities to embrace comprehensive, useful, and workable recommendations in the future. In terms of capacity building programs in the area of chemical safety and security, Indonesia welcomes the program and budget of the OPCW for 2018, as it includes significant activities relating to international cooperation and assistance, and wishes to emphasize that this should remain reflected in the organization's program and budget in the years to come. Indonesia remains fully committed to supporting programs where participants from states parties can share their expertise and best practices concerning chemical safety and security. This year, in collaborations with the Technical Secretariat, Indonesia has hosted three programs, namely workshop on needs assessment and best practices on integrated chemical management in Jakarta in March 2017, regional tabletop exercise on Article 10, assistance and protections in Bali last May, and a three-week industrial internship under the OPCW Associate Program in chemical companies. Mr. Chairman, Dr. General, distinguished delegates, Indonesia attaches great importance to the need for sustained and strengthened cooperation with the OPCW. Indonesia, therefore, is grateful of the first bilateral visit of the Director General of the OPCW to Indonesia on 26 to 28 July 2017, where a potential cooperation in the areas of mutual interest has been discussed with the Indonesian government and also with the permanent representative of ASEAN, as well as its dialogue partners in Jakarta. This visit shows the growing importance of the regions of Southeast Asia on the issue of chemical weapons. Furthermore, the adoption of the 12th East Asia Summit Leaders Statement on Chemical Weapons recently in Manila reaffirms the obligations and commitments of 10 members of ASEAN and its dialogue partners, namely Australia, China, India, Japan, New Zealand, Russia, South Korea, and the United States of America, to the Chemical Weapons Conventions, including the emphasis of the need to respond to the current development related to use and threat of use of chemical weapons or chemicals as a weapon. This is in line with the visions of ASEAN 2025 to preserve Southeast Asia as a region free from weapons of mass destruction as part of its contribution to global efforts on disarmament and non-proliferation. This also constitutes a reflection of unified voice of ASEAN together with other leaders in our collective and resolute endeavors to contribute further to the realizations of the objectives and purposes of the conventions. Mr. Chairperson, Dr. General, and distinguished delegates, my delegation is pleased to endorse the recommendations made by the Executive Council at its 86th sessions that Ambassador Fernando Arias Gonzalez of Spain be appointed to the positions of the next Director General. Rest assured of Indonesia's continued support and cooperation upon the discharge of his solemn duty. My delegation also wishes to congratulate the Director General, Ambassador Ahmed Uzumsu, and his team for their tireless endeavors and the achievements that have been made and for having put the OPCW in the head of a well-respected recognition. May I warmly convey our highest compliments to the General Ahmed Uzumsu for a job well done. Let me reassure my delegation's continued support and cooperation during the rest of his term. In closing, let me echo the distinguished speakers before me in conveying our full cooperation and support to you, Mr. Chairman, for the success of this conference. I request that this statement be included as an official document of the conference. I thank you.